Debouncing user input in SwiftUI can be tricky because of the declarative nature of the framework and how it manages state updates and view rendering. Unlike UIKit, where you have more control over timing and event handling, SwiftUI requires a different approach to delay and manage user input efficiently, especially when working with a published or a state properties. In this video, I will walk you through step-by-step how to implement debouncing the right way in SwiftUI so you can avoid unnecessary computations and improve your app's performance. And if you want to master SwiftUI in 4 weeks, go ahead and check out the link in the description for a huge discount. More on this later in the video. Now today, we are going to learn how to debounce some text. So when you are adding some text inside your text field in the SwiftUI view, you want to call, let's say, an API call on it to search. Let's say you are having a search bar and you want to search for some criteria. Now, it doesn't make really sense that you are going to search on each and every character added to that text field. You want to wait for the user to input their text and then call that search on your server. So this is what we are going to learn how to build out in SwiftUI today. What I have done is just created a brand new Xcode project, and basically we just have a content view inside the navigation stack, and here is my content view. We have a text field, and then we have a debounce text. So currently I'm just going to print it out, for, like show it inside the text field, but usually just want to call with that debounced text your servers. So what do we want to do? Well, currently we just have this text, and whatever we do is just going to automatically update itself. So if we are listening on an on change and then call the server, it's just going to do that on each and every character count. Now, as you already seen, I have this debounce text input file created right over here, and this is where we are going to create our view modifier that we are going to add onto our text field. So yeah, let's just start off by importing SwiftUI. And the approach will be that we are going to use a debounce view modifier on the user input. Now, what is that user input? Well, it has to be a published variable. I don't know if you already know that, but published variables under the hood, they're kind of using combine, and that's how we can debounce this published variable. So let's create our class. So a class debounced view model, and that will be an observable object, and then published var text. Well, I'm just going to change it to user input. So we are going to use this observable object inside our view modifier. So let's create that view modifier struct, debounced modifier, and that will be a view modifier. Let's see what we have right over here. I'm not going to go with this option. Let's just have our body, and that will need a content, and I'm just going to add in our content right over here, so we are not going to have any issues there. Okay, so first of all, let's use our observable object, and I'm just going to create a state private var, and that will be our view model and our debounced view model. There we go. Next, we are going to use this view modifier on our view. So we need to input our text that we are going to debounce. And after that, we need to also output our debounced text. So we are going to have two bindings for that reason. So at binding var text of type string, and let's duplicate that with command D, and then debounced text. Okay, so we have our two bindings, and also we want to let the user set the debounce time interval, so be it half a second, 1 second, or whatever they feel like. I believe 1 second is just fine, and we're going to set that as the default value, but anyway, we should be able to just let them set their time interval. So let debounce seconds, and that will be a time interval. Really nice. Okay, so those are the things that we need to input. And of course, the bindings are not inputs, they are just bindings. But let's just use now this user input. Here comes the magic. If you're serious about leveling up your SwiftUI skills, now is the perfect time to join SwiftUI Camp, my best-selling cohort-based Zoom bootcamp. With 80% off until May the 7th, you'll get 4 weeks of hands-on expert-led training designed to help you master SwiftUI fast. Whether you're aiming to build polished iOS apps or land your next dev job, SwiftUI Camp gives you the skills, structure, and support to make it happen. Grab your spot now. The discounted link is down in the description. So, dot on receive, and the publisher will be our view model, dot dollar sign user input, that's right, and then debounce. There we go. And we're going to call the one with for and scheduler. So for, we are going to go run loop dot schedule time type. That's right. And then dot stride with a time interval. So that will be our debounce seconds. And then the scheduler, we just go on the main. So run loop dot main. That's right. Now under perform, we are going to get back our value after the debounce. Therefore, we are going to set the debounced text to be that value. Really nice. Okay, now that we are adding it, we have that. But we are listening to the user input and having the text changed right over here. So before we even debounce, we need to set the user input to be our binded text. Couldn't be easier. We just have an on change of and on change of our text. And we are going to set, well, we don't care about the old value, so we just have an underscore over there. We're going to set our view model's user input to be our new value. So the text, the value comes through the binding of text. It just puts it on the view model's user input. And because this is a publisher, we can receive, so listen on receive and debounce it. And once it's debounced, we are going to put it back to the debounced text binding, which we are going to listen also. So that's how it works. Let's create a view modifier because, yeah, I don't really like the dot modified and then just add the debounce modifier. Let's create an extension on the view. There we go. And then, yeah, maybe this will work. Yeah, not really. So let's just create our, maybe public. It doesn't really matter. Public func and debounced. And then I want to add a text that will be a binding of string. We also need a debounced text. So debounced text. Again, a binding of string. There we go. And then the time interval. So debounced seconds of time interval. There we go. And here I'm going to set the default value to 0.5. This will return some type of view, and then we are going to say modifier. Yeah, that should be fine. Let's just see it. Okay, yes. So we're just using our created modifier. Now it's time to use it on the view. So here is our debounced text view. And if you want to present the text changes on the debounced text, you would just go something like dot on change of and then text, and we just say our debounced text equals the new value. Let's build and run and see how that looks like. Build succeeded, great. And if we type anything over here, we will see that it's over there. But this is instant. We don't want to search against that. So instead of this on change, what we are going to use is the newly created debounced text. And I'm just going to go with the default 1 second debounced seconds. Yeah, and there's a type over there. Let's just have dollar sign text and then dollar sign debounced text. Okay, and not delay. There we go. Let me just go back and change that debounced text. And there we go. Okay, so now let's build and run again. Let's see. Yeah, let's fix that. And now we should see that 1 second delay. So if I just type in here a letter, after 1 second, it will be there. And also I could just type. And then after 1 second, it's just going to debounce it. And we can call the server, which is exactly what we want. Now, if you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and also check out SwiftUI Camp, where you can master SwiftUI in 4 weeks. The discounted link is down in the description.